So we're still in quadric surfaces.
Yeah.
Hyperboloid. We need to talk about hyperboloid. Not just one of them, but two of them.
Yeah.
The first type of hyperboloid that I want to talk about is a hyperboloid of one sheet. Is it EET or is it EAT? I'm never going to get that. But a hyperboloid of one sheet is kind of like an hourglass. It's kind of like an hourglass. And you can call it one sheet because you would be able to make that shape with one piece of paper. It looks a little bit like this, where your Z is up and down in our usual orientation. Don't like that. Your X is coming out the board. And your Y is going out to the right.
Yeah.
All right, so let's look at the labelings of this hyperboloid. Here, A is going to be where the X axis intercepts your hyperboloid in the XY plane. So this out here, that's A. This over here is B. So similarly, this over here is a minus B. You see? Let's talk about C for just a second. We see that we have ellipses for our traces that are horizontal or parallel to the XY plane. And we have hyperbolas in the YZ and the XZ. And that's what C is going to do. It's going to control the pitch of your hyperbola. Your C here is what you're going to be making your rectangles with, like you did back in conic sections. Connect your diagonals. And the pitch of your hyperboloid of one sheet is going to follow those hyperbolas. Similarly, there's another one in your XZ plane. I drew the one in your ZY plane. Okay, let's go through and talk about the other type of hyperbola. Hyperboloid of two sheets. Okay, let's go ahead and draw this guy. Sure. Here, once again, in your traces that are parallel to the XY axis, you get ellipses. Awesome. You also get hyperbolas in your XZ axis or plane and your YZ plane. Sure. You're asking, why are we getting two sheets? This height here is C, and C, minus C. What's so important about that C, and why does it start and stop? Well, we have to take a look. We have to take a look at our Z over C components. Awesome. Z can be bigger than C. What does that mean? That means that z over c is bigger than 1. What does that mean? That means when I add this to both sides, I get a real ellipse. Yeah? Yeah. I get a real ellipse. If this is bigger than 1, we have to add it to both sides. Then it's going to be z over c, which would be a positive number on this side, is going to be bigger than that guy. Sure, giving you real ellipses. The trick is, and why this surface disappears in between c and minus c, is when c is smaller than z, see? You know? When c is smaller than z, see? Then z over c is smaller than 1. Also, z over c squared is smaller than 1. Yeah, why? Because that's a proper fraction, and a proper fraction squared is still a proper fraction. So now we have this number over here that's less than 1. When we add it to both sides, we get our numerical part of our hyperboloid equation. It's going to be negative, and that causes real problems, because now we have an imaginary ellipse in between c and minus c. See? So when you're trying to recognize the forms of these two hyperbolas, you're going to have one negative sign on your variable part. If the numeric part is positive, it's of 1 sheet. If your numeric part is negative, it's of 2 sheets. Notice how that imaginary ellipse doesn't happen over here. Whatever this number is, it's going to be positive. Then you take the negative, the opposite of it, and when you add that to both sides, you're going to be adding a positive number to both sides, and then this is always going to be positive, and you see? Okay, that's your hyperboloid of 1 and 2 sheets.